Hello, students. This is Aditya Tiwari. I teach here at Lukmaan Ias. Today with us we have Jay, and he have qualified civil services examination and have secured a very good rank. So let us have a chat with him. So congratulations, Jay. Please tell me something about yourself, your background, and what optional did you take, and how the strategy that you have adopted by qualifying it.
First of all, thank you. Thanks a lot. And I would also like to thank whole Lukmaan Ias for providing me this opportunity to interact and fulfill my sense of responsibility towards fellow aspirants. About me, my name is Jay Shivani. I have secured All India Rank 81 in this year's Civil Services Examination. My optional subject was Mathematics, and this was my second attempt. Last year also I reached till interview stage, but then I missed the final list by 25 marks. And this year, fortunately, I am able to qualify it.
Okay. So, what is your academic background? What did you did?
I passed out in 2017 from IIT ISM Dhanbad, and my discipline was Bachelor of Technology in Computer Science and Engineering.
Okay, so as you have taken mathematics, very unconventional subject, you know, most of people don't take it. So any advice on that how to choose optional, or even if someone is from IIT or some, you know, technical background, how to go about it? Because most of the people who have technical background, they are supposed to take sometime geography or pubad or some writing subject, but you have taken a very unconventional route. So what were the reason behind it?
According to me, the most important factor that should be behind selecting an optional subject is the interest. If someone has interest in any subject, be it technical or be it humanities or be it any science subject, one should go with it, and also then opt for the right path and right direction in that, for that subject only, because interest matters the most, because you have to put in a lot of hours in optional subject. If you're not interested in any particular subject, then you cannot carry on with it for long, and this journey can be shorter also, and unfortunately a bit longer also. But then if you have interest in particular subject, then it's okay. So interest is very important, and once you have decided, then guidance should be taken from various sources. If someone is joined in a coaching institute, then the guidance comes from there only. If not joined in a coaching institute, then guidance from seniors and batchmates preparing, and also the internet, it helps a lot. And then preparing in the right direction consistently, results will come through.
Will help you a lot. Okay. So one more thing I wanted to ask you, since you have taken this test series from here, Lukmaan Ias Ethics, right? So ethics is somehow very, you know, different from all other subjects, right? So any guide or any strategy that you specifically followed for ethics?
Ethics is, as you said, it is really very different from all the other GS papers, and after being introduced in 2013, a whole composition of general studies has changed, and distribution of marks between various papers has also changed. Ethics is something in which what I feel is that input-output ratio can be better compared to other general studies paper. If we put in a good amount of work in it, then output can be expected in ethics. For strategy part, what I feel is ethics paper, introduction of ethics paper was really good for the process of selecting candidates, because if someone has a right reason and intent to prepare for this examination, and his or her thought process is good in general, then tackling case studies part in ethics becomes really easy, because whatever natural thought process you come through after reading the case studies and after facing any situation, if that is ethical enough, then that should be written in it, and nothing extra preparation is required on content wise. But then for structure and presenting the answers, the preparation is required, and for that test series helps a lot. And that's why I joined this test series, and also then discussion of the test by Ansari sir, that helped in structuring and presenting the answers of case studies or of part A also.
Yes. And one more thing that we were talking earlier, you didn't take any coaching, right? Yeah. Only you have given test series. So how you did that? You know, most of the people feel like that without test series, you know, without coaching institutions joining, you can't qualify, right? And so fellow candidates who will be appearing the next years, what advice would you give them, you know, those who cannot afford or somehow is not able to take coaching? So what strategy you followed, right?
What I think is, for this particular examination, the academics or the knowledge base is not that much difficult. Like comparing it with IIT JEE, that I also cleared IIT JEE, the knowledge base and the academics part was a bit more difficult than compared to this examination. What requires in this examination is the consistency and the right direction. So if someone joins a coaching institute, they provide a right direction and guidance if someone is not having one. But they cannot, one cannot be rest assured that if one has joined a coaching institute that he'll clear or he or she will clear the examination. Self-study becomes really important in this examination. So in my case, I was in college when I started preparing for this examination, and I was also not having any guidance for how to proceed like everyone. And then I was also not having the option of joining a coaching institute for getting for exact direction. So then what I did was I discussed it with my seniors and those who were already in the preparation of this examination, and then also the internet. These two things helped a lot in getting the right direction. And once a candidate gets the right direction and right source to study, then moving consistently in that direction is only what is needed. And I don't think that coaching institute matters that much after that.
After that, it means if you have a consistent performance and if you have right guidance, you can do it without your coaching institutions. Okay. And one more thing I wanted to ask you, that since you had mathematics and you have very good marks in interview also, so for interview, what did you take any coaching or you have prepared something specific for the interview?
Preparation is required for interview, specific preparation is required. But what I feel is interview is a personality test. So the base of your personality will remain the same, because that you have developed from your childhood, and what you are. So what is required in preparation is that, I say it every time, that you have to be a better version of yourself by just tweaking some things in your personality. You cannot change your personality completely in 1 month or 2 months time. But by preparation, you can be a better version of yourself and not any other.
Okay, so what questions, any question that they specifically ask about your subject or about your general?
Actually, this time unexpectedly, two of the members asked me questions from physics and chemistry of 11th and 12th standard. So that was really unexpected for me. One.
Since you are from IIT,
right? Yeah.
So they might have.
Yeah, they but then they went back right to 11th and 12th, ignoring all the engineering. Yeah. So, and the other thing that I liked about the questions asked in the interview is that there were like quite a few situation based questions, like if I am posted as a DM in particular place, what issue I'll address. If I am posted as an IPS officer in Dhanbad, how will I address coal mafia situation? So these questions really intrigued me and I liked them.
And so concluding remark, right? So most of the candidates will see you as a guiding light, right? And since your case is quite unique that you haven't taken any coaching, only test series that you have prepared, right? So, you know, in few lines, kindly conclude that what message would you like to give to the candidates?
Message I would like to give to the candidates is that there are two, three things I would like to say.
Yes.
First of all, the reason for the preparation has to be correct in this preparation. If you have a right reason and right intent for the preparation, then you keep motivated every time and you don't need any external motivation for that. Even if unfortunately the journey becomes a bit longer, then also you don't reach your saturation level and you are inspired every time. Other thing I would say is then the result of this right reason is consistency. So if one has to maintain consistency and be patient, it can take one attempt or two attempt or even more. But if one is patient and is taking every result positively, be it a failure or a success, if the result is being taken positively, then ultimately what you have thought of will be achieved and result will fall in place automatically.
Always be inspired, self-inspired, right? And one last thing about Lukmaan, that you have given multiple series. So any specific thing that you liked about Lukmaan?
One specific thing that I liked about Lukmaan, and also the reason of joining Lukmaan, was that what I thought that ethics is the paper in which I wanted to put in more. So that I wanted an extra test series. So then deciding Lukmaan was, I heard from my seniors and from my batchmates that discussion classes after the test with Ansari sir were really good. So then even I experienced that. He goes into a very detailed discussion of a test and covers various dimensions of writing an answer and how to structure it well, how to present the answer well, and how to make the life of an examiner easy, so that it is easy to check your paper and he awards good marks.
I mean, making the life, yeah. So he deals with every other aspect. Okay, so thank you very much, Jay, and best of luck for your civil services career.
And all the best to everyone.